Meanwhile, Ukraine has denied Russia's claims that it plans to use dirty bombs and attack nuclear power plants. President Volodymyr Zelenskyy's government has described the accusations as crazy Russian propaganda.
Imagine waking up to this. Firefighters in action after a blast tore through a car park by a row of apartment blocks early in the morning. A reminder that Russia's war in Ukraine hasn't gone away, even as Ukrainian forces push further into Russian land. Local officials say this was a Russian missile strike. Shocked residents inspect the ruins of their cars and recall what happened.
It was terrifying, a feeling of helplessness, knowing you can't do anything. Everything was burning.
Olena believes Moscow is retaliating against the city of Sumy for Kyiv's invasion of the next-door Kursk region. But she still supports Ukraine's offensive.
Let the Russians know what it feels like to wake up at 4 in the morning, gather their children's belongings and run, not knowing where to go.
2 people were injured in the explosion. Everyone appears traumatized. Nastia says these window blinds saved her life by stopping the glass from smashing over her and her boyfriend as they slept.
I'm happy to be alive because, as usual, I sleep at this side to window.
She says she needs to get away from here to recover.
I want to live in this city in Ukraine, but it's bad memories this place for me, and I don't know what to do in the future.
Yeah, what do you wish for?
I wish for, of course, peace.
No sign of that for now.
A missile caused the damage here, and there's also been a significant increase in attacks from glide bombs since Ukraine launched its invasion into Russia. In fact, while we were at this site, the air alert went off and we had to move away because Russian aircraft were in the sky.
But on the Russian side of the border, it's the Ukrainians on the attack. They even brought a group of journalists in on a brief tour. The arrow to the right points in the direction of Suja, a newly captured Russian town. On the roadside, the carcasses of war, a common sight in Ukraine now littering Russian soil. Inside the town, a statue of the former Soviet leader Lenin stands damaged in an assault that happened on Vladimir Putin's watch. A global nuclear power no longer in control of all its land. For civilians here, as in Ukraine, there's fear. The poster reads, "Peaceful people in the basement, there are no soldiers." This is the reality of Kyiv's desire to bring Moscow's war home. A battered sign by the border points to both Russia and Ukraine. But no one knows which way this war will end.